This video is going to show you how to use the Mann-Whitney test that is on the VassarStats site. So I already have open the Google Sheets that has the data that we're going to use. So I'll go right to the VassarStats site by clicking there. Then we're going to go over here and click on Ordinal Data. Now, Mann-Whitney test. Now, the first thing it wants to know is our sample size, or more specifically, the size of each group. They call them here A and B. Don't confuse that with column A and column B. So you have a sample, in this case of our example, it's a sample size of 50. But the two groups are 26 males and 24 females. We have to enter the larger group first. So it's going to be the 26 males and then the 24 females. So I go 26. Then the other group, females, is going to be a little bit smaller at 24. Okay, now I'm going to scroll down. And you can see we have places to put in the raw data. So I'm going to go back to the data sheet, and I'm going to look at the variable of social class. That's the variable we're going to compare the two groups on. You're going to use some other variable in your assignment. So I'm going to copy all the data in that column for the males. In other words, row 11 through row 36. Copy. Now I go back to the VassarStats site and I just paste it in. Now I go to my other sample. Go back to my data. Get in the social class variable. And now I'm going to highlight rows 37 through 60, which goes along with our female group. I copy that, go back to the VassarStats site, and paste in those data. Now, over here, it says import data to data cells. So I'm going to click there and watch what happens down below. The raw data now goes here. And as you can see, I have 26 data points for the male group and 24 for the female group. I now click to calculate from raw data, and automatically it ranks all of those subjects, and it goes ahead and calculates a two-tailed p-value that you see right here. And that's just not quite good enough. That's 0.07. That's maybe in the marginal range at best. I don't think we can reject the null hypothesis.